So you find yourself at work one day in a conflict with a coworker, and you're not really sure how to deal with it. So you go to Google and you type in, what is the best way to resolve conflict at work? And you find that, you know, there's a lot of different answers that Google is giving you. And that's because, you know, there's maybe not one best way to resolve conflict at work. There's a lot of different effective approaches. And among these effective approaches, there's a common thread between them that indicates maybe best practices for dealing with conflict at work. And so that starts with normalizing the possibility of conflict. A lot of people want to think of conflict as this taboo occurrence, and they, because of that, they want to avoid it at all costs. But avoiding it doesn't fix any of the problems that are underlying that conflict. And so from the outset, employees, leadership, organizations who normalize conflict, recognize it as a normality among everyday life at work, is a really great first step. And from there, you can move on to the second step here, that is providing training to employees on conflict resolution skills and communication skills, because that is really what is going to equip them to deal with conflict constructively. And so when that training has been given, setting clear expectations around conflict is really important. Recognizing that, you know, when I get in this conflict, that I first will engage in this practice, then I'll do this and I'll utilize this skill, is super, super helpful, because then employees aren't lost when they inevitably find themselves in conflict. And then finally, once those clear expectations have been set, there is a truth to encouraging tensions to create new ideas. Conflict, although often thought of as this destructive force, is neither positive or negative, but can lead to destructive or constructive outcomes. And these constructive outcomes happen to be, in a lot of workplaces, greater innovation, greater creativity. And so encouraging conflict that spurs that kind of activity, that kind of behavior, is extremely important. So these four ideas of normalizing conflict, providing skills and training, setting clear expectations around conflict, and then encouraging healthy tensions to spur innovation and creativity, I would say are among the best ways to resolve conflict at work.